Hello MTV, welcome to my crib. Welcome to Vivian's official nursery tour. You guys have been asking for this video for a little while now, and now that we've been able to get everything finished in here just in time for her to arrive, I figured I would do a little bit of a walkthrough for you, so come on in. So starting in this zone over here, this is like Vivian's little diaper change area. Right now, I'll give you guys the disclaimer that this is not where we're actually changing her diapers. We have another mini kind of like postpartum set up in our bedroom right now that this moves over to. And then we've got a basket of like diapers, wipes, all the things that you would need in the middle of the night for that. But when she actually does move into this room, this is where we'll do diaper changes and things like that. So we've got the changing mat over here, a little mirror that she can look into because she loves to look at herself in the mirror during diaper changes. And then we've also got the Ubi diaper pail down in the corner here. We went with the Ubi because you can actually use your own grocery bags and garbage bags to throw stuff out. So it's a little bit more economical, and it also has got like a great locking feature, so you don't smell anything when you come into her nursery, which is also great. In her drawer here that I just repurposed, it's Facebook Marketplace find, and then I added the IKEA handles to it. So in here, we've got all of the things that you would need. We've got our diaper section. We've got a bunch of things over here like Tylenol, Bright Water, which luckily we haven't needed to use yet. We've got wipes, we've got lotion. And then over here are some of more of the like accessory type items. So I've got all of her bows and pacifiers in here. This is all hats up here. These are little bloomers. And then over here are all of her socks and stockings that we have right now. And then we've got backup sizes in the corner of that as well. I'll show you guys what we have right now for sleepers and onesies and stuff like that. So this is everything that we have up to 9 months for sleepers and onesies, minus what is in the wash because she's going through multiple outfits a day. So these are all of the newborn sizes. This is like 4 months, kind of a little bit larger. And then this is like the 6 to 9 months. We did have to pack up quite a few newborn sizes when we came home with her, but we're finding that things that are like 0 to 3 work really well, so we've got a lot of great stuff for her in here. In this drawer down here, we've got all of our kind of like other baby essentials, so all of our swaddles go in here. We use the Halo swaddles and also the Nested Bean swaddles, which are her favorite because they kind of simulate a hand over the chest, and she really likes to be held when she sleeps, so that one works really well for us. I've also got baby carriers and baby wraps in here, and then all of her towel and kind of bathing suit type items as well. So over here, we have more storage in this IKEA shelf. In the top shelf, I just have a little wicker basket that's all of her bath stuff. So we've got her bath towels, her brushes, shampoo, body lotion, all that stuff. And then down here, this is kind of a mix and match of some breastfeeding stuff. So I've got breast milk storage bags as well as all of the nipple pads in here. And then down below is the beginnings of her little library. So for my baby showers, we had people, if they were able to, do a book instead of a card. And that has been so helpful for us just to get a bunch of books going for her because every time she's awake, I try and read to her. So we've got a really great collection going down there. Up here, we have our Hatch noise machine, which we've been using every single night since we brought her home from the hospital. It's really nice because all you have to do is tap it and it will kind of change with different sounds and colors, but we've pre-programmed it to the one that works best for us. So we do kind of like a soft yellowy light with the sound of waves because I feel like it sounds the most like a gentle white noise that would sound like what it sounded like for her in the room. This is my favorite corner of her bedroom. We have the little fly sat shelf from IKEA with a few more books up on here. I also just put her little name tag that we used for her birth on here as well, which we got off of Etsy, just because I thought it was a cute memory to have in her room. But this is one of my favorite features. So I actually got this rattan hanger system, I guess, from AliExpress. And guys, it took like months for it to get here, but it was so worth it for me because I thought it was so cute when I saw it. And it also matches these little rattan hangers that we have from Petite Nordic Boutique in Ontario. So that was really important for me to be able to display those really nicely. So essentially, as she grows, I'll just put some of my favorite outfits of hers on here, and eventually she can pick out her own to kind of display in the room, which I thought was like a fun way to add some decor with all of the cute baby girl clothing we have. So over here, I have my little nursing setup. So I've got a little lamp up here that I can actually just step on with my foot when I walk in the middle of the night, which is really nice. We got this lamp off of Facebook Marketplace as well, and it didn't actually have a lampshade on it, but I found one at HomeSense for $6, and it was the perfect size for it. So most of the stuff you're seeing in this room is a lot of like Facebook Marketplace finds, HomeSense finds. So I'll link as much as I can, but the tricky thing is I did get a lot of it just like hodgepodge in lockdown and quarantine. So luckily it all turned out, but over here is where I can come in to nurse if I want to, if we've got people over or I want to come in here in the middle of the night. So we've got right beside the nursing chair all of the essentials, receiving blankets, burp cloths. This is what I find myself really reaching for when I'm nursing, and I wanted it to be really close to the chair. So this is the little nursing nook. So over here is Vivian's crib. This is just the basic crib from IKEA. I don't remember the name of it, but it's like $99. It's the most economical crib that you can get. So we are actually really happy with it because it matches the rest of the kind of boho design that I went with for the nursery. So above the crib for decor, I wasn't sure what to do because I know that babies can reach for things after a certain point, but I think this will work really well for us for now. We've got these frames up here. They were like three for $30 at HomeSense, so I grabbed those because I thought they were a nice like silvery gold that complemented the rest of the room. And then inside each of these frames, I actually DIY'd that as well. The pompous grass is from our cottage in Ontario, which I thought was kind of a cute thing for her to have in her room. And then the one that's in the middle there is actually just from a park by our house. So it was a very affordable way, literally $30, to do all of the artwork above her crib. For baby monitors, we ended up going with the Owlet. We heard that that one was really great, and we also loved that we could just pair it with our phones and using Wi-Fi. So basically, this is sending footage to my phone right now. If you guys can see that, it tells us the temperature of her room, whether it's too hot or too cold. It's 1080p footage, so we're getting some great footage in this room. I've already tested out just putting in here, and Jared and I just walked away and like took screenshots of her because we were like, oh my gosh, look at her on there. So we really love this so far, and I'm sure it will be a huge lifesaver to us when she's sleeping in her crib as well. All right, so here's the grand reveal of her closet. When we first moved in here, this closet was obviously just the entire wall over here. And so I figured that was a not efficient use of space for a baby, because with this like top hanger up here, you can only hang so many things and they're so tiny. So I wanted to come up with a DIY solution to make this a lot more efficient for what we needed it to be. So on Facebook Marketplace, again, I picked up this shelf and just painted it. It got it to match the rest of the room, and now I'm using it for storage. But the other thing that I did to maximize this hanging space was actually get just curtain rods off of Amazon. So these are just connected like with the wall and with the shelf, adding the tension there to hang these clothes. And then up here, we've got all of the different size tags. So I organized by newborn, 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9, and then that kind of goes down here all the way up to like 18 months plus. So we've got a really great way to organize all the different sizes, because as you guys know, if you're moms, the clothes are like very hard to tell what size they're in if you don't have an efficient way to organize that. So over here is more of her stuff that we've got right now. So just shoes up on the top level right now. And then over here, I have all of my breastfeeding stuff. So this is like bottles, pump stuff, backup formula in case we ever need it for whatever reason. This is postpartum stuff. So Mama Strut stuff, you guys know I love them, worked with them with my postpartum recovery. Some Earth Mama products like Sitz Bath, all of that stuff. And then down here right now is just extra storage. So some of the toys we've picked up. This is a keepsake box that I'm already starting to collect things in from the hospital. Up top, we're just storing all of our diapers right now. Obviously, we have so many different diaper sizes. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4, so we're gonna be good for a little while on the size front. But we've been using Pampers Pure for her, the Pampers Pure wipes as well. At this point, we've tried literally every single other diaper that you can have, and Pampers Pure is by far our favorite because they're the biggest, they're the best for her, but they also have the line on the back that lets us know if she's gone to the bathroom or not, and that is a lifesaver when we are changing her and we're on the go, so we super love their products. The last part that I'll show you guys is the light that's in her room. So this light is super special to me. I got it on Etsy. It was actually handmade for her bedroom from Thailand, which if you guys don't know, Jared lived in Thailand for a few years. And Thailand is also where her dad and I went for our honeymoon after we got married. So it's kind of a little ode to her dad, but also to her mom and dad and just that time in our lives. I have to have Jared close all the blinds for this to show you guys what he did with the light bulb, because he put in a fun light bulb for her. He's already the fun parent. This is probably not something I would have done on my own, but all right, we'll show you guys what this light can do.
Basically, it's just a light that you can adjust the brightness on, but then the cool part for her, especially as she gets older, is that you can change the color of the light, which changes the color of her nursery.
And then you can coordinate the hatch sound machine.
Yeah, so between
so the that light and the sound can match.
A little bit of magenta and teal.
We're gonna teach her her colors this way.
Yeah, we can.
Great.
And then you can turn the ocean sound on and make it blue.
Yeah.
Great.
She's gonna have so much fun with that.
But it's really helpful when you can control the light level in the middle of the night.
And it's on like our little remote as well, which is super, super nice. I bet you that will be her favorite feature of the bedroom. Well, thank you guys so much for watching Vivian's nursery tour. As I mentioned, I'll try to include as many links as possible in the description box, so be sure to check that out if there is something that I showed you guys or mentioned that you want to try and shop for yourselves. Obviously, as I said, there was a lot of products like from HomeSense and from Marketplace and all of that, so I won't be able to link those things, unfortunately. But if there is something that you guys are looking for your nursery and you want help finding something similar, comment down below and I'll see if I can give you guys a hand as well. It was so much fun putting this room together, even though I did the entire thing in lockdown. And luckily, I was able to do all of it for a little less than $1,000. So literally everything from crib, carpet, dresser, the closet makeover, DIY, all of that stuff. So there's definitely affordable ways that you can make it all happen if you have a vision and a dream for the way that you want your baby's room to look. So thank you guys for watching again. Be sure to like this video before you head out today and subscribe for more content like this. And we will see you soon.